Okay, hello students. Today I am giving topic on module 1. The module 1 belongs to system software. The chapter name is Introduction to System Software. Till now you studied about module 3 and module 4. It's for compiler design. Now I move on to module 1 for system software. And this syllabus cover Introduction to System Software and machine architecture for SIC and SIC bar XE. Now we have to study about in this chapter these two architecture. In fourth semester you studied about 8086, 8088, like that preprocessor architecture. The same way in this chapter you have to study these two architecture, and for these two architecture you have to solve how to generate an object code. For this system software you have to refer new book, The System Software by Leland L. Back and D. Manjula, third edition. For this topic you have to refer these chapter 1.1, 1.2, 1.3.1 and 1.3.2. And let me move on to what you mean by system software. For the introduction, first tell me what is software. Software is a program or collection of programs which are used for creation, preparation and execution of other programs. Then software can be developed by using programming language. Then what is the different types of software? The software can be classified into application software. Application software is nothing but it is a general purpose program or collection of program written by user to solve a particular problem in his or area of interest. What is the example? You can take any example. For example, railway reservation system or library management or airport system for any bus reservation. For anything you can say variant application oriented example. Then what is system software? Okay, it is a collection of programs written for computer system management, and these are developed by manufacturer. You know already system software, some assembler, compiler, loader, linker, operating system. Okay, now from last 1 month you study about compilers. Compiler is also one type of system software. Okay, next I have to study about assembler, loader, linker as a system software. Then the third type of software is utility software. What is utility software? It is a system software designed to help analyze, configure, optimize or maintain a computer. It is also one type of software. The example is antivirus software and backup software. I already explained in the classroom regarding these types of software and explanation. And classification of system software. Then system software can also divide into the three categories. One is operating system software. The operating system software, you have a one subject in this semester. In detail, you can study in that subject. The example is single user, DOS is an example. Multi-user, Unix is an example. Next, language processor. The language processor is also called as what? Cousins of compiler. You already studied cousins of compiler in module 3. Okay, in this assembler, compiler, loader, linker, interpreter. These are the example for this. You can go assembler. What is assembler? Assembler is a language. It is to convert assembly level language into machine level language. Compiler convert high level language into machine level language. Then loader, it loads your object code into memory. Link your sub program into memory. Interpreter, it's same as compiler but line by line compilation. The last one is system utilities. It is an example for editor to type your program or something else. Then if you have to debug to check your errors. These are the types of system software. The main question in the exam for the 4 marks, the compulsory one question is difference between application software and system software. Then you what you mean by application software? The application software is one side, system software. Application software, it is a machine independent. It's not dependent any of the machine architecture. But system software is a machine dependent software. The second one, they are primarily concerned with solution of some problem using computer as a tool, focus on application, not on computing system. What do you mean? If you want to write any software, for example, if you want to write any for the library management software, then you don't want to know about what is the architecture of machine. Only you have to concentrate then what is the requirement for the library system, borrower, buyer and number of books and what is the time, all the things you should be know. It's no need to know about register, memory, for that is not required. Then system programs are intended to support the operation and use of computer itself rather than any particular application. The meaning is system software is mainly dependent what type of operations are available in systems software. And third one, it is does not bother about efficiency in application software side. System software, the main goal of system software is efficiency. Then fourth point, application software has not bother about machine architecture. That means it not required machine architecture. They do not have worry about register set, addressing modes and its usage. System software. System software are more keen on machine architecture. The keen is nothing but dependent, more dependent on machine architecture. The example, assembler or compiler need to know machine architecture very well in order to make efficient conservation. That meaning is then assembler is mainly dependent on architecture. 8086 assembler will not work with some other processor architecture like that. Then application software generally make use of system software as a tool for their development. Okay, there are certain system software which are not directly connected with underlying machine such as loader and linker. And what is the example? Library system, railway reservation. This example, anything, compiler, loader, linker, assembler. Don't forget in the exam for writing example. Examples also carries 1 marks. Okay, next. The next topic is the machine architecture. Very, very important for these architecture for the 10 marks for the exam. Okay, different types of question will be coming for this. Okay, this is continuous till at the end of the chapter. Don't forget any one of the architecture. The first one is simplified instruction computer. It is also called as SIC. Simplified instructional computer with extra equipment. It is called SIC bar XE machine. Okay, let's move on to the first architecture. The first architecture is SIC. As like your 8086 or 8088, you should be studied about what is memory, addressing mode, register, data formats, instruction format, instruction sets, input and output. You should be studied about all those things we called as an architecture of SIC machine. In exam, you will get the question is, explain the architecture of SIC machine for 10 marks or explain memory, addressing modes, register with respect to SIC. For each carries 2 marks. The question can be anything, but it's a compulsory 1 question in module 1. Okay, let's move on to what is the first one. With respect to SIC, we'll be talking about memory. What is the memory in SIC? The memory consists of 8 bits called as a byte. Then any 3 consecutive bytes form a word. 3 bytes form how much? 24 bit. Then words are addressed by the location of their lowest bytes. Then the last one, all addresses are byte addressable and total memory capacity is 32,768 or in terms 2 to the power of 15 bytes in computer memory. These 5 points you should be remember if with respect to SIC. Don't forget, because the same thing will apply to SIC bar XE machine also. Then register. Then there